Now, getting up, what gets you up in the morning? Bizarre picture to choose, but...
I'm a writer. I mean, getting up in the morning isn't really part of my job.
I used to leave the World Service on overnight, but just very quiet on the radio at the side, so I thought I'd wake up sort of quite naturally. But I was listening to Radio 4 on the way to work the next day, and I heard the news on the radio, and I thought, I dreamed this. For 2 days, I thought I was psychic. Because I'd been dreaming what I was listening to on the World Service. I thought, oh, my God, I've got the powers.
Are there ones you know of? Did you ever use as a child if you didn't have an alarm clock?
This was the old wives' one. Bang your head on the pillow the number of times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
And you would wake up at six.
Yeah. With concussion.
Do you not? Have you not heard that?
Not tried that.
You maybe have to have been at a boarding school. But we used to do, like, if you were, we were doing a raid on the kitchens or something, we'd say, OK, we'll get up at 3 and we'll go down to the kitchens because they have these big blocks of catering jelly and you'd eat the blocks of jelly.
Left out specially for the ones who are going to raid the kitchen.
Yeah. Probably.
The kids have been raiding the kitchen again, better leave some jelly out.
But we would go bang, bang, bang like that, 3, and you'd wake up at 3. And it seemed to work. We were convinced it did work. Sleep researchers say that it doesn't. You just wake up a lot because you're not sleeping and you look at your watch and then you only remember the one that works.
But... You've got a tremendous headache, by the way.
You've got a headache the later you want to sleep. You say you don't get up early, but are you a night owl? Do you work later?
No, I can get up early, but I have to.
Yeah. So it's reckoned that 20% of people are genuinely, you know, it is a difficulty for them because they are... They are larks or owls, as you might say. They are early or late, and that's to say they fall asleep at dinner parties if they're a lark, and they just can't get up if they're an owl.
Teenagers are owls, aren't they?
Young children are larks, and teenagers are owls, and then very old people tend to get back to being larks again and rise very early.
But it's very irritating. If people do get up very early, they will justify that by saying, best part of the day, best part of the day. It's not, it's just part of the day. I see
when
another bit
open.
Of the day.
There are things that happen early in the morning that are different if you've stayed up for them than if you've woken up to them, like it's 3 or 4 in the morning and you're having an all-nighter and you hear the bim and you feel guilty and you hate the fact the morning's come. If you wake up to it, you think, yes. Belongs to me. It's a big difference, isn't it?
I used to live in a house in Herne Hill and I had the room at the front and there was one bin man who thought he could sing and at 6 in the morning he would come and he would sing Don't Cry For Me, Argentina. But he could never get the last note. So he'd go, Don't Cry For Me, Argentina.
No!
Well, it used to vary morning to morning. And I was that close to insanity because he was, you know, he was my lark, every
Rex
morning.
Harrison did your bins.
Yeah, two sisters called Argentina, didn't you know?
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.